priest, according to the Bible scholars. And he said, Hosea, present Lord, Hosea, I want you to get married the great Lord. I want you to marry a prostitute. What, Lord? A prostitute, naman. In Tagalog, it does not sound well. Pakasal mo isang puta. Okay, sabi. Ang pangit pakinggan eh. Hindi ko ginagawa dito. Baka sabihin ni President Duterte, ginagaya ko lang ang sabihin ko yan. No, but, Hosea obeyed. And they had children. 1, 2, 3. Oh, Hosea was happy each time. But after the third child, Gomer was no longer happy. And he left Hosea and went and became a prostitute. Prostituted herself. And God could have told Hosea, go, denounce her. And then, once she's proven guilty of adultery, have her killed, stoned to death. That was the law. That was the law. But God said to Hosea, go and take your wife back to yourself. And you know, Hosea went, looked for her, and found her being sold, auctioned. Nakasubasta na. Basta-basta na lang. And Hosea gave all the money that he had. 15 shekels. Mura na lang yun, half the price of a slave. And 15 barrels of grain. Huh? Mura na lang. Very cheap, because she had cheaper than herself. In Tagalog, sabi natin, mura na lang, dahil ukay-ukay na. Nevertheless, you can, and you know what Hosea said? He's what he said. Stay here and wait for me, and I will wait for you. In English, let's start all over again. That is the way God loves. And that's how God wants to make us. Oh, you prostituted yourself. I will give you back your dignity. No matter how low you have become, no matter how low you have sold yourself to the devil, I still want you. And I love you. And when you are mine, what does that mean? We are one body, we are one flesh.
Amen.
You're united with me, you share my life.
Amen.
Beautiful, no? And that is true. It's not bollock, no. It's true. But you know, came a time when Israel had a kingdom, and they had a king. Their second king was a wonderful man. And he conquered his enemies all around. And when he conquered his enemies, well, there were a few more enemies outside. He sent some of his army out there also to conquer them. One day he was surveying from the roof garden of his palace in Jerusalem. Beautiful city, more beautiful than Singapore. And then he looked down on another roof garden. Ooh, someone more beautiful. But she was taking a bath. And the eyes of David grew big, and his heart pounded very much. No? Very much. And he said, I want that woman, call her. Invite her to my palace. And she came to the palace, and they had dinner, and then they had wine, and then they had music, And then, etc. You know nothing. You don't know what happened. No, in other words, he committed adultery with her. And after a few days, Bathsheba said, I am pregnant. And of course, David was surprised. Pregnant? What's going to happen? Look, I will be exposed. I will be exposed. Imagine, I took for myself the wife of one of my captains who's fighting out there in Mindanao. Imagine, he would be exposed. So invited, he asked, send him to me. And the captain came, and he just go to your wife. Said, no. My companions are fighting in the field, and I how will I go there? Okay, next day. Come, go. We have R&R, Mama, rest and recreation. No. I cannot do that. Oh, come, let's eat. Third day. Eat, drink. Then he made him drunk. They said, go home. He would be exposed. So he sent his general a letter. Put him in a dangerous position. And when the fighting is hottest, leave him alone. And then, that's what happened. I put Captain, he died. And Bathsheba, okay, mourned for her husband. But after days of mourning, you know what Bathsheba said? Huh? She came to David and she said, here I am. Did you call me? I have heard you calling in the night. Allah. And then he thought, no, and they then had a child. Oh, everything covered up. Nobody will know anymore what I did. But what happened? Nathan the prophet came to him. Nobody knew, but God knew.
Amen.
And Nathan, to make the story short, because I might be speaking too long. Nathan, he said to him, you know, there's a man, very rich man, with many sheep. And then the neighbor, with only one sheep, but he loved him. He even made him lamb, eat at his table and sleep with him in bed. Loved him very much. But when this man had a visitor, and he said, I want to give him a party. And he held a party. He killed not one of his sheep, but the beloved sheep of this man, the poor neighbor. And David got angry. He said, that man must die. He pronounced a death sentence on himself without knowing it. And Nathan said, you are the man. And you know, David was touched by the grace of God. And he said, I have sinned against the Lord. And you know, surprisingly, Nathan said, the Lord on his part has forgiven you. And you know, David then became the ideal Israelite king. That is what God's love can do. It can pick you up from the mud and put you on the throne and make you the best king of all.
Amen.
That is the power of love. But many more. But we now go to the climax of it all. Because Israel did not seem to learn its lesson. Israel was like us Filipinos. Back to back, sin and sin, sin again, sin again, sin again. We never seem to learn. And they never seem to learn. Until God said, read this in Jeremiah 31:31. That is not for you to use for lotto number. Jeremiah 31:31. God said, I will make a new covenant with the land of Israel and with the land of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with your fathers. A new covenant. In other words, hindi nadadala ang Diyos. This is what Pope Francis says. God never tires of forgiving.
Amen.
Never gets tired of forgiving. God said, another time. Another time. And this time, the best. Ito nakakagulat. When we give God the worst, His love gives us the best. Naniniwala ba kayo?
Amen.
That is true. And you know the best that He gave us? His Son. This time He sent as a Redeemer, not the ideal King. No. He sent His own Son into the world. When the Galatians 4:4 says, when the fullness of time came, God sent His Son, born of a woman, born under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons, that we might become children of God. Not only good men, not only very great men, but children of God. And this Son came among us, and He became Emmanuel. God is with us. That's why I do not like the song, He loves us from a distance. No, our God is Emmanuel. Amen. God is with us. God is with us. And, you know, what did he do? Look at that. I only select a few. Otherwise, you will spend the whole day here. Brother might be left to speak for later, no? But I, you know, but look at this. Somebody with a demon. Demon? Demonio? Okay? Demon on the grass. Who are you? Ang sagot. We are, I am Legion. Nako. Legion, that's 1,000. Nakakatakot. Kung nakakatakot ang isang demonyo, lalo nakakatakot ang 1,000. But, Jesus was not afraid. And He said, God, the devil, ask, oh please, don't let us, give us permission to go to the pigs. And you know, there were 2,000 pigs. And Jesus said, go. And when they got into the pigs, the pigs rushed headlong into the sea. They all died. Puro lechon noon. Ang daming pigs in there. You know, the Israelites could not even eat lechon. Could not. Huh? So, but Jesus, for Jesus, one man was more important than 2,000 pigs. Remember this. One man more important than even 2,000 pigs. He would release the man from the devil, even if it would cost 3,000 pigs. That's how Jesus loves people. Amen. He loves people more than things.
Amen.
Remember that? Amen. He loves people more than all the money in the world.
Amen.
And, okay, that's one. Another one is that Mary Magdalene. She had 7 devils. Can you imagine that? You and I probably have only 1 devil each. But Mary Magdalene had 7 devils. What that means is either she was very bad or she was very crazy. As one companion priest of mine said, neither of the two will do. Well, but you know, Jesus loved her and drove out 7 devils from her. And what became of Mary Magdalene? You know what became of Mary Magdalene? She became one of the bravest and the closest of Christ's disciples, staying with him till the cross. One of the other disciples ran away, patakbuhin. Mary Magdalene stood by the Lord. And when the Lord rose from the dead, he made Magdalene the first of the bringers of the good news. May nagbibiro, kanya daw si Mary Magdalene, kasi babae. Pag sinabi mo sa babae, sigurado kakalat ang balita. But that was not the reason. Well, Mary, Jesus wanted to show what I can do with you and for you. Even if you're the most evil, I can turn you into the best of saints. Even if you were bad news before, I can make you a bringer of the good news.
Amen.
Hindi ba maraming ganyan tayo sa El Shaddai? One time I was talking against the killings that are happening in Manila, and one of the disciples came to me, a very good preacher, and he said to me, Bishop, tama kayo. You're correct, Bishop. You know, I was a drug addict myself before, and if I had been a drug addict at the time of Duterte, I would have been killed perhaps. I said, but he said, now, Bishop, look, I'm able to preach. And he's a very good preacher, very good student, very good father also. You see, from an addict with drugs to an addict of Christ.
Amen.
Look at God. Another person. One tax collector, chief tax collector. Perhaps corrupt talaga. A collaborator. Ang pangalan Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus was 4'10" in height. Money. When Jesus was passing by, he would try. He said, "Teka, nagtiting kayo." Hindi ko makita si Jesus. Wouldn't see Jesus. So he climbed up a tree. And when Jesus saw him in a tree, he said, "Zacchaeus, come down. I must stay in your house today." And Zacchaeus went down and prepared a party. And people said, "Oh, this man, Jesus, has entered the house of a sinner and eats with him." In other words, they were hitting Jesus and at the same time hitting Zacchaeus. Huh? And Zacchaeus, who had now met the Lord and had received him not only to his house but into his heart. You know what he said? He stood up his full height of 4'10". And he said, "I give half of my money to the poor. And if I have cheated anybody, I give it to him back 4 times." Oh, God. What a change from corrupt to giver. That is how the love of Christ can be changed.
Amen.
And one of the best examples in life, when Jesus was already dying on the cross, and there was somebody dying with him, a thief, magnanakaw. We call him the good thief, and we translate that into Tagalog as mabuting magnanakaw. No, that is not mabuting magnanakaw, that's magaling magnakaw. You know why he was magaling magnakaw? Because on his last moment, imagine, he said to Jesus, "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And the Lord said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." He stole not only a few million, he stole paradise. And he stole it when he was dying. He was such a good thief. He died stealing. Yeah. And Jesus gave it to him free, gratis, at the moment. And that is what Jesus can do. This is what Jesus wants to do to us. Oh. Look. Our reading a while ago said, God is love. And how did we know that? We know that not by looking at the stars. We know that not by looking at creation. We don't even know that just by studying the history of Israel. How did we know that? Because Jesus came to us. Listen to this. God's love was revealed when he sent his only son into the world that we might have life through him. This is love. Not that we have loved God, but that God has first loved us and has sent his son to be the sacrifice that takes our sins away. God is love. We know this because of what he has done for Christ. I'm going to ask you. Tell me the truth, huh? Tell me the truth. Do you love me? Ay, ako mahina yan. Do you love me?
Yes!
It's getting louder. So I believe you. You're not lying, no? Are you telling the truth?
Yes!
Okay. I believe you because you look so truthful. When I look at your face, you look like canonized saints already. Pwede na kayo ang mukha na kayong kinanin. You're truthful. Okay. But what if, while I'm speaking here to you, a terrorist came in, suddenly, and grabbed me by the neck and put an armalite onto my head. And you maybe would react. And the terrorist says, keep quiet! I will not kill this bishop. He does not only have big eyes, he has such a big voice. He disturbs me, I'll kill him. And you say, no, please. Why not? We love him. Oh, you love him, huh? Yes. Do you want, don't you want me to kill him? What is your answer?
No.
Oh, no, okay. I will not kill him because you love him. I will not kill him on one condition. One of you will take his place. Now be truthful. Raise your hand. How many of you will raise your hand? Ay, mako, salamat, sister. There is one. One, I'm going to faint. Only one. So many said to me they love me. But look, listen to this. Romans chapter 5. Listen. It says, it is difficult to die for a good man. Though for a man who is really worthy, a man might be prepared to die. That's why I'm not surprised naman. I am a good man, but you're not willing to die for me. I'm not surprised. See, Paul says that. But, he says, God proves his love towards us because when as yet we were sinners, Christ died for us. Amen. And that is why, even though not one of you is willing to die for me, or there's at least one, I will not go up the top of the highest building here and jump down. Instead, I jump with joy. I jump with joy because God has loved me and has sent his son to be the sacrifice that takes my sins away. That's God's love. That's God's. And this is what St. Paul says. I put St. Paul. He who did not spare his own son but gave him up for us all, how can he fail to grant us all things with him? He gave his son. What more will he not give you? remember this. Pag sinabi mo sa Diyos, wala na akong pag-asa, sabi ng Diyos, may bukas pa. You have a future. Why? Because I love you. How do I know? I gave you my son. If I gave you, what more will I not give to you? Remember this. God will give you the best, even though you may have become the worst. I know that. I will not give you details, but I know that in the depths of my heart. Kung may nangyari sa buhay ko, hindi na ako pupulutin sa basura. Pupulutin pa ako sa ilalim ng dagat. But God says, I have taken your sins and have cast my your sins behind my back. That is what God does. Come to me and listen. This is not me. Though your sins be red as scarlet, I will make them white as snow. Though they be red as crimson, I will make them white as wool. Who would ever think? Us, Brother Mike. Brother Mike tells his story of his old life. Just as many Elizabeth preachers tell the story of their old life. But look at Brother Mike now. What God has done to him. What God has done for him. What God has done with him. He will never have thought that in the beginning. But now, okay. Well, there's a time not even Sister Belen could be proud of Brother Mike. Not even Sister Belen. But now we're all proud of him.
Amen.
Because of what God has done. Because of what God has done. And let me tell you this. The Bible tells us that God is able to accomplish more than what we can ask or imagine. Don't ask little things from the Lord only. Ask the best.
Amen.
And you know the best really is, Lord, make me your child. There is nothing greater than a son of God. If you're a son of God, you're much better certainly than what some people call son of a bitch. If you're a son of God, a daughter of God, you're even better than the president of any country, amen, of any nation. Yeah? If you're a son of God, you're better than the whole world put together. Because Christ could not have died for the world, but he died for you and me.
Amen.
Okay, malapit na ako matapos. Be happy. This, you know, God showed his love through Christ. But that's not the end yet. Don't think that that's the end. Don't think that Christ's work for us ended with Calvary. It did not even end with his resurrection. You know what? The completion of Christ's work came when he sent the Holy Spirit. And listen, pakinggan niyo. The love of God has been poured forth into our hearts by the Holy Spirit who has been given to us.
Amen.
Notice. Kung tayo'y nauuhaw, nauuhaw kayo, palingan niyo, dalawang po kayong magaganda dyan. And I say, oh, drink, but only a little. Kaunti lang. Drink, ikaw, a little. Only a little. And I'll give you only trickles because you're so many. But you know, God, He does not give in trickles, He pours.
Amen. Amen.
Iba yung buhos sa patak. Yung patak. Yung buhos. Sabi ni Jesus, if anyone thirst, let him come to me and drink. Let him come to me and drink. You know, St. John says, he's sent up of the Holy Spirit. Yes. Sabi ni Jesus, out of his belly will pour out rivers of living water. Rivers. Hindi bottles. Rivers. Meeting na nyo?
Rivers.
Kunyan, mga ilog. Bubuhos. And where is it for? Into our hearts. Why into our hearts? Kasi, alam nyo, pag inig siya na kayo na gawin, put it into your veins, it works well, no? But, when they put it directly into your heart, nako, it circulates very fast. So God puts it right into the center of ourselves, into our hearts, so that we might be changed. Amen?
Amen.
Ngayon, eto. I ask you now, in connection with Father Sunny. Okay. Do you believe that God is love?
Amen.
Do you believe that God loves you?
Amen.
Do you believe that God has poured forth His love into our hearts?
Amen.
Do you believe that?
Amen.
Now, I want to see proof of it. And how? What is the proof of it? Simple lang po ang proof of it. Ganito. Painumin, you give me vinegar, I drink vinegar, what will my face look like?
Sour.
Sour. If you give me ampalaya,
bitter.
What do they call that in English? Ampalaya?
Bitter gourd.
No? Bitter gourd. If you give me bitter gourd, how will my face look like? Bitter. Bitter. But if you give me honey or ice cream,
sweet.
How will my face look?
Sweet.